So join us in celebrating 25 years of God's faithfulness. Please feel free to invite your family and friends. Without further ado, let me introduce the speaker today, which is Pastor Sandra Chin. Pastor Sandra Chin is an illustrative and down-to-earth teacher. She has been involved in youth and campus ministry for over 20 years together with her husband, Pastor Kenneth Chin, through the Ministry of Asian Youth Ambassadors, AYA, and X-Church. She's the Senior Minister and Missions Pastor of X-Church in Subang Jaya. Kenneth and her have been involved with church planting in 8 nations with 38 weekly services globally. She has a passion for raising leaders and seeing them fulfill their God-given call in extending and expanding the purpose of the kingdom of God. Let's welcome Pastor Sandra.
Good morning, NLCC. Good to be with you this day. And thank you once again to Elder Simon and Elder Albert, and also to all of the leadership for having me join you for service today. Praise the Lord that this is a new day, and I'm sure we're all, you know, waiting. Well, I am waiting to be able to get back out there, get back to my workplace, and be able to makan at the mama, you know, and to really see people. That's me, right? I really tak boleh tahan stay at home, but anyway, I've been a good girl. So I hope all of you are keeping well. It's been some years that we last met, and I trust that everyone is doing well. Praise God. So we're going to pray, and then I will start sharing. Hallelujah. Amen. Shall we pray? Let's pray. Thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you for this morning. And Lord, this is the day that you have made. You have granted us good days. And today is a new day. And I pray your blessing over your people right here in your church. Father, you refresh and renew your children. Father, we are waiting on you. We are looking to you. We are listening to you. And we are just waiting upon you, Father, knowing that you are the one who will direct our path and who will deliver us. And we pray that time will allow us to meet each other again this morning as we come to your word. Holy Spirit, help me to bring God's word, and that will be encouragement to your body, Lord, encouragement to those who need this word today, and that your church may, Lord, be refreshed and renewed and continue to grow and run after you, Lord God. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for being with us and for being right there in our homes today. Father, I submit myself to you. And for everyone who's listening, Lord, as we have worshipped you, Lord, as they have touched heaven, I praise you and thank you that heaven will come down and meet with us as we meet with you today. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody say, amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Okay, my husband, Kenneth, sends his regards to all of you. Again, so happy to be able to join you here. Okay, this morning, I want to share with you on this message, and I understand there is a theme this year, and I just hope that what I'm sharing will also tie in with your church team of growing, you know, into the likeness of Christ and being equipped, amen? Yeah, praise God. So the title of my message is Remembering. Okay, remember? Do you remember? And I just thought that it's such a you know, such a time for us to remember while we are waiting and while we are just you know, just trusting the Lord in this time and this season. It's good to remember, and I pray that as we remember things that God has spoken to us, we are going to be able to move forward. Amen. To live with such hope. To live in faith, to live with the fullness of Christ and not with fear. Amen, church. Amen. Praise God. And and so I want to share with us on this thought about remembering. Amen. So, you know, I kind of draw out from this thought from the Word of God. And every time I realize, and I don't know if you realize it, every time when you read, you know, God's Word, many times He speaks to His children and to the people of Israel, and He tells them, you know, to remember what He has done. And he's such a good father, isn't it? Because He knows how we are such forgetful people. I'm quite forgetful. Sometimes forgetful until not very thankful. So not good, not good. So it's good to remember, amen. And to and to be able to remember is to be able to see what God has done in the past, and then it gives us the grace to move forward. I see God as the one who also remembers. And so in this verse that I just want to draw out from Genesis chapter 9, verse 12 to 16, and you know the story about Noah and how they went through the heavy rains for 40 days and 40 nights. And you know, all of the man was destroyed. All of men, the earth was destroyed. People were destroyed or killed or drowned. And then this is what God says. So Genesis 9 and verse 12 to 16, it says here, and God said, "This is the sign of the covenant which I make between me and you and every living creature that is with you for perpetual generations. I set my rainbow." Don't we all love rainbows? Amen. This belongs to God. Yeah, God made the rainbow. "I set my rainbow in the cloud, and it shall be for the sign of the covenant between me and the earth. And I will remember my covenant of which is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh. The waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. The rainbow shall be in the cloud, and I will look on it to remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is on the earth." Amen. So, I mean, I'm just looking at our Father God, who says that He set up a rainbow in the clouds so that every time the rainbow comes up, He will remember not to destroy the earth or the people therein or any living creature through a flood. So that speaks a lot about even God Himself putting a sign, and so that when He sees it, He will remember, and He will, you know, even He, because if you read the verses before, you know, God also kind of like very saddened that He had to, you know, do this, you know, flood and to wash out all the evil. And He said, you know what, I'm not going to destroy living creatures again through a flood. And so I'm going to make a covenant with you, you know, Noah. And this is it. I will never again have a flood to destroy all flesh. And every time I see that rainbow, I'll remember my covenant. Our God is a covenant-keeping God. And when He sees this rainbow, He will remember. And so as we draw out, we want to be like Jesus and you know, into His likeness. And one of this likeness, you know, our Father God remembers when He sees a symbol or a sign. And so that's where I'm drawing it from as we walk through this time and this season or this climate where, you know, things are so uncertain. Some days maybe you might be thinking, you know, what's going on? But I want to say, if God can look at something and remember, I believe it is a reminder to us that we too can remember. Amen. And so I'm going to go through with you some verses just so that it will establish to us what is God's word to us on remembering. All right. Now, God used different signs or elements to help the children of Israel to remember. All right. He really set up different signposts so that whenever they tend to might suddenly forget, but when they see this sign, or if they have this festival, or if they were, you know, going to eat something, they will remember. And so we're going to go through just some thoughts to help us digest this and break it down a little bit, okay? And I'm sure you are familiar with these verses, but I just thought today is a great day to bring this word to you. And so one of the verses that that we have here is Exodus chapter 13 and verse 3. And Moses said to the people, "Remember this day in which you went out of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. For by strength of hand, the Lord brought you out of this place. No leavened bread shall be eaten." So the Lord says, remember every time when you have this, you know, when you keep the Passover, remember, and you have the unleavened bread, remember that no leavened bread shall be eaten. And so the Jewish culture is that they always celebrate the Passover and they have the, you know, unleavened bread, because the leaven had represented sin. Today, as we study that, and God said to remember. So every time when they, you know, are going to have the Passover and they're going to celebrate with the unleavened bread for 7 days, what happens? They will remember how God delivered them from the house of bondage, and that they will give thanks to the Lord. Amen. And now we're going to move down to the next verse. And this is taken from Numbers chapter 15 and verse 38 to 41. And this is what it says. "Speak to the children of Israel, tell them to make tassels on the corners of their garments throughout their generations, and to put a blue thread in the tassels of the corners, and you shall have the tassel, that you may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord and do them, and that you may not follow the harlotry which your own heart and your own eyes are inclined, that you may remember and do all my commandments and be holy for your God. I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt to be your God. I am the Lord your God." Amen. Isn't that amazing that, you know, God would just such a detail at the corners of their garments, they have the tassels, and then a little blue thread that is woven through it. And he says, every time you look at this, remember to keep my commandments. Wow, you know, to follow the word that I've spoken to you. You know, today we might not have tassels in our garments, all right? We're a bit different, but we have the written word of God, and we can see our Bible. I know a lot of us may not carry any more, you know, printed Bibles. We should, because every time you look at it, you remember it's God's love letter to us. It's God's word to us. Amen. And as we, you know, open up the word of God and do his commandments, or to read it and do his word, you know, we remember our God. Hallelujah. He says, "I am the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt." He's the Lord our God who has translated us out of darkness into his marvelous light. And so he spoke that to the children of Israel. And even for us today, we have God's word. Amen. We might not have a blue threaded tassel, but we can imagine why the Lord would put little symbols, little signs here and there, so that, you know, when they get busy and if they suddenly decide, "I'm going to do something else," oops, hey, they see this tassel with that blue thread, and they go like, "Oh, I have God's word. I will remember what God has done for me. I will not, you know, play the harlot to the Lord." And so that's what God put, a little symbol for them. He says, remember, you know, two times in this scripture, remember. Amen. Okay. The next scripture that I found is found in Deuteronomy chapter 8 and verse 18 to 19. And this is a great verse. It says, "And you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth," amen, "and that he may establish his covenant which he swore to your fathers, as it is this day. Then it shall be, if you by any means forget the Lord your God and follow other gods and serve them and worship them, I testify against you this day that you shall surely perish." Now, this verse here is about God reminding them, if you read the verses above, of how God has blessed them and has put in them the ability to be able to do well, right? To be able to do business, to really flourish in their work. And he says that, remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth. Don't forget that it is I and not you. And so that, you know, the people of God would not be proud and say, oh, it's me, you know, I'm so good at this. But to remember it's the Lord. He is always so good to bless the work of our hands. Again, the Lord asked them to remember. And what is that? Every time they do well, remember it is the Lord. Such a good thing, isn't it, to always remember what God has done for us. And so those are just some of the verses that, you know, that helps us draw from the Word of God. And then we can, as we look at what God's Word says, how can we do what we can do even today? So I wanted to share with us these thoughts of what God, what we can do in this time. So, you know, remembering causes us to give God praise in all things. Amen. Remembering causes us to give God praise in all things. Every time you think about the Lord, you remember Him, you can't think of bad things, right? When you think of God, you think of good things. I mean, can you imagine sitting down at home, just remembering where you're at and you have a roof under your head, you just say, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to give you praise because I have a roof over my head. If you've got health today, you're going to say, praise the Lord. I remember I'm God is so good. He's kept me well. Yeah, it's good to remember because remembering always brings our mind back to the Lord God and not just about ourselves. And so remembering and what I've written here causes us to give God praise in all things because there's so much to give thanks to the Lord for. Amen. Remembering causes us not to keep the eternal to ourselves, but to share Him to others. Amen. As you have so much to give thanks for, every time you remember that we have eternity. If you know the Lord Jesus Christ, you have eternity. And God has given us eternal life. So when you remember and you sit down, you think, what can you give thanks for? What you say, wow, I have eternal life. And because you have eternal life, you can't keep it, right? You've got to share it with others. So you remember, okay, I better share with someone, okay, about my eternity and how I found this eternity in Christ. But when we forget that you have eternal life, then we might become a bit like, you know, like thinking, wow, what's my future? What's my future? Your future is, you know, anchored in Christ. And that's why, you know, we have so much to be grateful and thankful for that we have an eternity. Why? Because God has translated us, as I said earlier, from darkness into His marvelous light. And today we live with such hope. Even when things don't look cool on the outside, we know in our hearts we have eternity. We have eternal life. God, who is eternal, has blessed us so much to look forward to. We can't keep it. We need to share it with somebody. So think of someone that you can share your eternal life with, you know, like so that they too will have eternal life and will know the love of Jesus. Amen. All right. And third point, remembering is to take time to reflect and to be reminded of the good God has done or what others have done. So when you remember, again, you reflect. Sometimes you have so much, you know, today we are working from home. These past few months, these 1.5 years, we've been working from home. And some days, if you just sit down and you take time to reflect, right? And then you're reminded of the good that God has done. Even when you sometimes you cannot find, right? Oh, what good thing? You got to remember and think, you have health. You know, you can eat, your systems, your plumbing system all working, right? You went toilet, all the plumbing system working, you're well. You reflect and you think, what can you really, you know, remember of how good God has done or even what others have done for you? Many times we are very forgetful people. I'm quite forgetful and sometimes very quick to, you know, blame. You know, we end up, instead of being, you know, thankful or being praising God or, you know, just saying thank you to someone, we try to find a lot of wrong. It could be with your spouse, you know, like, why you buy the wrong noodle? Every time, you know, and use the word every time. Don't use that word every time. You know, to your spouse or to your children, every time you're like that. And we can't, You know, and you can't keep doing this over and over again, like every day. It becomes unwell for your being. And so as you reflect, and then you're reminded how good, you know, some you can find good in the people that have helped you once before. What was the good that they've ever done for you? It could have bought you a meal, someone could have been kind to you and others weren't, offered you a seat. You know, someone, maybe, again, it could be the closest people, your family, you know, who remembers your birthday and then, but, you know, didn't buy the right present and you're like, so, but if you remember, they think, okay, God is still good and there's good in people. And that way, we won't really, you know, try to find fault all the time. This is important even in the life of the church. If we remember a little bit more, we won't be so fast to get angry with our leaders, get angry with our home leader, get angry with our members, that person, this person. I think there's too much forgetfulness that we forget to remember the good that people have done. I'm guilty. And that's why, you know, as I prayed and I've been thinking of this message, I do need to repent because it's good, right? Because we say we remember, we will learn to praise God. Amen. And then when we remember we have eternal life, then we shouldn't like live as if we have no hope. We have so much hope because we have eternal life and we've got to share this with somebody. Amen. And that way we can remember the good God has done for us and the good of what others have done for us. Amen. The other thing about remembering is about when remembering brings about thankfulness and it helps us to be grateful for the kindness God or others have shown to us. So people are good to us, but then there's kindness. Part of the fruit of the Spirit is kindness. Amen? To be like Christ is to bear the fruit of kindness. So when we remember a little bit, when you sit down, you think, then it brings about thankfulness. I think one of the virtues in our Christian walk, and if we're going to shine as lights in a dark place, is learning to be thankful. My husband really does not like people to be ungrateful. I know the wife, lah, and sometimes ungrateful. maybe I never say thank you. Maybe I'm like, aiyah, these are not good enough. I don't like this food, lah. Aiyah, today I don't want to eat roti, lah. Roti canai. I don't know. You know, just sometimes just not. Just say thank you, lah. You don't just say, okay, great. I think it's a good thing to be thankful. Amen. Because as we come about, you know, as we bring ourselves into a place of being thankful, then it helps us to be grateful for little things or big things. We don't so fast, you know, get upset. And then we think about, you know, God has been so kind to us. And if God can be kind to us, we can be kind to others, to extend the kindness of Christ to others. We're not all very patient people sometimes. We like things our way, and so we might not be kind to somebody. But as you think about how good and kind God is, or how God has allowed other people to be kind to you, so I got that others have shown kindness to us, be thankful. Like develop a heart of thankfulness or gratefulness. I think too often, instead of reaping the blessings of God, we might reap, you know, negativity or non-blessings when we constantly, like if you wake up in the morning and you know, do you the first thing, what do you say praise the Lord, do you say good morning, do you find things to pick on your family member, you know, yo, why you never do this, why you never do that first thing in the morning. I experience this sometimes in this my home. Someday, some family member might go up like, "Oh yeah, you didn't take the trash out first thing in the morning." So I think it's good to be thankful because you remember how good and how kind God is to us. He didn't, you know, judge us because of our sin. He didn't judge us because of something I did or didn't do. I am so grateful that I am not judged, like zapped. Like in the book of Acts, sin and God. No, God has given us chances upon chances, U-turns that we can take to return to the Lord or to have, you know, thank God. God is so good. He gives us second chances. And that's why we too need to give others second chances. I'm learning. It's tough sometimes. Like, you feel hurt, you feel pain. I'm dwelling a little longer because this fruit of gratefulness and thankfulness, it just flows out because we remember how kind God is to us. And out of that, we thank the Lord, we give thanks. And then when we remember how others have been kind to us, we also learn to be kind back to other people because someone else was kind. It's important. Otherwise, we will be very grumpy. We'll be very ungrateful. We will be, you know, just because we're not having the things we want. But yet the Word of God continues to ask us to have the fruit of our lips, which will be praises, right? So if we're praising God, then we won't be unkind or saying unkind things. And we'll be constantly giving thanks to the Lord. Amen. Just a reminder there, church, that I'm not speaking just at you. I'm speaking to myself as well as a reminder. Amen. And then another point about remembering is remembering helps us not to allow roots of unhappiness and bitterness to remain. When we remember how good God is, as I'm saying above, just like a bit of a repetition, because we are remembering how much goodness is going around us and how God has been kind to us, or how sometimes different people have been kind to us, then as we remember again, and even if we have the tendency to want to get upset with someone, and like, why this person say this thing about me? That's not fair. Well, life is not always fair, but God is a just God, and He does things according to the principles of His kingdom. Paul says in Philippians, rejoice. And again, I say rejoice. And you're like, I got nothing to rejoice. Yes, you do. Find something to rejoice. Even when it's bad, you have to say, wow, let's find the good in it. Because if we don't, we'll be very unhappy. Everything will be unhappy and unsettling. And I've seen people like this all the time. It's unhappy. You know, I meet them, there's always a negative word. And you know that when you have unhappiness and negativity, or because you feel offended and you feel like someone has robbed you, hurt you, didn't do the right thing, you start getting a little bitter, and then you respond in bitterness as well. And then all your joy will be robbed away. And that's because we forgot that God is good to us. Ah, right? And God doesn't want us to have any roots of bitterness. Ah, so we need to be remembering, and then as we remember, we say, Lord, never mind, thank you, I still have life in you, and I have, you know, fullness in Christ. Amen. All right. And that's where we're at. The five thoughts of why remembering is good for us. Hallelujah. I just want to encourage you, church, because we're living in a time and in a day where I think people need a sense of hope, or a sense of how we can live freed up from too much heaviness and, you know, so much confusion. We're all waiting for something. And while we are waiting, instead of just waiting and just laying back and being unhappy, we remember. And that is for us, church. That is really for the believers, for the children of God, as we are wanting to develop and to be equipped and to grow in the likeness of Christ. I think some of these very simple, basic things of remembering. That's why God, throughout His Word, church, if you read His Word, He keeps telling them, remember. You know, He gives them festivals, right? All these festivals to celebrate, all the different feasts, right? Why? To take a long holiday, like it goes on for 7 days. Why? As they take the holidays, they were to take, to remember God. Why did He say, you know, take the 7 days rest? Because after, you know, 6 days of working, as you rest, wow, you can see all the good things that God has done. And even in the midst of trials and the midst of challenges, we then once again come back to that resting, that place of rest, of remembering that God is still in control. I just have some little short takes here. In case you're thinking, okay, how can I remember some things, right? So I've got these few little, small little thoughts here, five ways to remember the Lord, five ways to remember the Lord. And the first one, what I use sometimes as an analogy or a picture is, you know, a pebble, when you tend to get a little bit, I'm so lost, or I'm going through such a difficult time, and you look at a pebble, for me, it's a pebble, for you, it could be something else. So you find things that will help you also to remember. So when I have a pebble, is to remember that Jesus is my rock. Amen. Jesus is my rock. So He is my stability. And you can see that in 2 Samuel 22, 2, you know, David says that the Lord is my rock, my fortress, my deliverer. So sometimes if you have a rock, and because we are forgetful, ma, so when we see this rock, don't just look at it, oh, it's a rock. For me, that rock symbolizes that Jesus is my rock. Amen. He's so stable and he will help me. And he will, he's my fortress, he will deliver me, I will not be shaken. So something that you could look at sometimes, you know, because we are forgetful people. And so I look at that. How about a pair of scissors? So a small pair of scissors reminds me that I need to cut off all the unnecessary stuff that is causing me stress or distraction from the main goal, okay? Some days there are a lot of things that are pulling at us or trying to distract us. I will say to us, hey, we can, you know, when you see the scissors, you think, what can I do with the scissors? I know it's just to cut paper, but it's also in a spiritual sense, you know, we can, like, in our minds, take this spiritual scissors and, okay, I'm going to cut off this unnecessary thing, okay, this burden, these words that really are so bad, negative from someone, I'm just going to cut it off. I'm not going to take it because it's not true. Or things are distracting you from the main goal, right? Because Philippians chapter 3, verse 13 to 14, you read, Paul encourages us to run forth, you know, forgetting those things that are behind, those things that are done. Some of it is unnecessary, it's past. And we're still dwelling there. It says, no, run and move forward towards the upward call of God, the goal that is to finish this race, run towards Jesus, take away the distractions, keep the main thing, you know. What's your main goal? God has called you to be, you know, his light, and he wants you to run to him. He has a great call for our lives. Amen. So sometimes you have to cut off, let go of a lot of things. Otherwise, it will just burden you and you can't really live out the fullness. Another thing that you could use to remember God, I have this bottle. Sometimes you have a little bottle. Now, why? Because a small bottle to remind you that God has collected all your tears. He knows you inside and out. Sometimes we, you know, feel nobody understands us and we tears inside, tears outside. But the Lord says he collects your tears in this bottle. Psalm 56 and verse 8. Go ahead and, you know, read it for yourself. Psalm 56 and verse 8. God collects your tears. He's the one who's going to deliver you. He's the one who's going to answer that prayer. He's the one who comes and soothes your heart with his peace and his love. So, you know, when you look at a bottle, yeah, it's a bottle. You use it for many things, but it's also a reminder, God collects our tears. So somebody sees your tears. If nobody else does, God does. And he will come and comfort you. And that gives you a sense of comfort, right? Cool. Fourthly, there's this thing about the candle. Now, when you have a candle, remember candle to remind you that you are the light of the world. Amen. You are the light of the world. Don't blow out your candle even if you are the only light standing. Sometimes you feel like, oh, I'm the only light in this place. Let me just blow out my candle so I can be like with everybody. Hello, don't. If the whole place is dark, one candle will light up the whole place. And Jesus says to us in Matthew 5, 14 to 16, you are the light of the world. And let your light so shine so that the people will see it and they will glorify your heavenly Father. Amen. Shine for the Lord. When you see that candle, and sometimes you feel like, I don't know if I should even, you know, be around people. You need to be around. God's love, God's light in you will be such an encouragement, and you shine for him. Don't blow out your candle. He is speaking through you. You and I, God's, you know, the type of Jesus, the Jesus with skin on, that anyone will ever see, the closest thing about Christ is in and through you. So if you have a candle, remind yourself that you are God's light. Amen. And lastly, your phone reminds you that God is only a call away. Amen. Jeremiah 33:3, your emergency number. Call unto me, says the Lord, and I will show you great and mighty things. Our Father is not deaf that he can't hear us. His hand is not too short to help us. Call on the Lord. Call on the Lord. Sometimes we tell everybody about a problem. But as you remember, as you look at that phone, you remember, hey, what can I do with my phone? Aside from calling people to tell them to complain about this person, that person, or, you know, I'm trying to find help. Remember that you can call on the Lord. I know, not like dial, but in a sense, through that promise of Jeremiah 33:3. Remember, you can call on the Lord. Bring to God all of your prayers, all of your needs before you bring it to men. Too many times we bring all our needs to men, or we tell them about our problems, but they cannot help us because only the Lord is our helper. Amen. So that phone is a good reminder. Now, these are just little things that help us to remember God in the midst of different things. Why? As we remember, you know, gratefulness will just flow out from our hearts. Thankfulness will flow out from our hearts. I just want to say to you, dear brothers and sisters, remembering is part of God's vocabulary. It's right there in His Word. And as you take time to remember, may the Lord bring encouragement and help you to grow and help you to bear the fruit of the Spirit. And as you bear the fruit of the Spirit, you know, others around you are going to be so blessed by your life. And that is what His church is about, isn't it? Abiding in His Word. That's why God said every time, you know, you think about doing something, you remember My Word to do My commandments. And He had them, you know, writing words and putting it in their frontlets. They call it frontlets on their head to remember God's Word. Today, we don't bind the Bible on our heads, but we keep the Word of God in our hearts, right? So that we might not sin against Him. We remember. I just say, you know, God is ever so good. He's always near to us. And as a church, and today, you know, we're not even able to meet one another, to connect with one another. More so, we still have a reason to still shine amongst our friends or people that you might connect with, your colleagues, you're working from online. People are seeing things in you, how you speak or how your countenance is, or, you know, how you just remember to do a word of kindness or just sweetness out of your lives. It will be such a blessing. So I want to bless you with that word again, church, and allow me to pray for you as I close at this time, and also believing for God to do His miracles in your life and in the church. Looking forward, I believe you're all looking forward to meet again, and maybe I'll see you sometime. Praise God. Why don't we pray and just lift our hearts up to the Lord at this time. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I thank you for this opportunity to share with our brothers and sisters here in NLCC. And you know, God, you're so good to your church and how you have drawn your people and kept them safe, oh Father God, and kept them so hopeful. Lord, this morning, the word of remembrance, and just as we remember, Lord, that's what you spoke in your word. And that is how you desire for us to build our lives around, remembering the good word of God, the truth. And it's true, Lord. Jesus said that when we know the truth will set us free, Lord. And may the truth of God's word continue to abide in our hearts, to take the good word of God and allow your word to just work in us. Lord, there's also the ideas of gratefulness and thankfulness and of remembering. And I pray for everyone who is watching from home. Perhaps someone is just going through a difficult time. Maybe there's someone at home, you know, you're maybe there are things on your mind that's heavy, or maybe it's a work situation, a family situation. Maybe that you're stuck somewhere in your heart, there's some heaviness. I want to pray in the name of Jesus that the Lord will lift you up. And I say that when He lifts you up, that you would also remember again that God is faithful. He will never leave you nor forsake you. And the Lord will lift you up and give you even a lightness of heart, because He is always near. He is never far. Amen. Lord, you bless your children. And Father, for those who are not well today, I want to extend the prayer of healing. If you're not well, lay hands on your body or wherever that is not well. I want to declare the healing of God, because He is able to heal us. By the stripes of Jesus, the Lord heal you. The Lord grant you your deliverance from that infirmity, because the infirmity cannot dwell in your body any longer. By the stripes of Jesus, you are made whole. God has sent His word to heal you and deliver you, to deliver you from that pain in your back, from that heaviness in maybe in your head. If there is a sickness of cancer, even God would nullify it and totally remove that out from your body in Jesus' name. Oh, even for those who might be, you know, concern about taking the vaccination, just pray the Lord keep you from all side effects and really protect you as you do to go forward for the vaccination. Thank you, Father, for healing the bodies of your children, healing them from every sickness, infirmity, healing them also, Lord, from their heart, you know, just heart issues as they today remember you again and bring forth words of thankfulness and gratefulness that they will just sense a light, a lightness, a lifting up of burdens and just be able to see how good you are and see that there's an eternity that they have for their future. Lord, we can only stand to rejoice and be so glad. Thank you, Lord. Bless your church and keep everyone in your perfect peace until we meet again. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody say, Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Again, God bless you. Thank you so much to the elders of the church, the leadership, for having me here with you to share God's word with you. Hope to see you soon. God bless you and take care.
Thank you, Pastor Sandra, for the message. Surely there's so much to remember, all the good things that God has done for us, to us, and also the good things that others have done to us. And of course, the most important is to remember the truth, and Jesus is the truth. Okay, let's close in prayer. Thank you, God, for all the good things that you've done to us, O Lord, and all the good things that you've experienced through others, O God. Thank you for everything that you've prepared, O Lord, and provided. We want to thank you so much, O God, for all of this, and praise you, God, for all of this. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And now let's close with a benediction from Romans 15, verse 13. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you and see you again next week. What kind of love would stand in the flames and choose to remain there beside me? What kind of love would go to the grave, give up everything just to find me? Of all the treasure that this world could offer me, you're the greater love.